What went on between Rachel Berry and Mr. Schuster long before acting in Glee? Could it be love? All the countless romances Cord Overstreet had, and which Glee star dated Brad Pitt himself? Hi, I'm Lisa, you're watching OSSA, and here's everything you need to know about Glee real-life partners. Lea Michele. Since she considered herself a natural leader, Rachel Berry will be up first in today's list. This bright, charismatic, and incredibly talented Broadway singer made the producers laugh out loud after the first few lines of her audition.
"This isn't supposed to be funny, that was my serious thing. I'm gonna do it again and I won't go all crap."
And though the laughs she was getting made Lea worried, it turned out to be a good sign. The actress became a Glee icon and left her footprint in the history of musical theater. There's a rumor that her stern character is not only evident on screen, but in life too. That's why in her 33 years, she managed to change many celebrity boyfriends, and you will not believe who made it to her list. Number 1. Matthew Morrison. Shocked? So am I. Few of you will know that a couple of years before acting in Glee, Rachel Berry dated her on-screen teacher Will Schuster. Even though Lea denied these rumors, she later confessed in her book Brunette Ambition that the affair did happen, which made the fans very happy. I had worked on Broadway with Jenna Ushkowitz and Matthew Morrison before. Matt had been a friend of mine for years, and in fact we'd actually dated back in the day for a Broadway beat. Since both actors don't like to talk about relationship, we are left guessing what could possibly go wrong. After Morrison, Lea dated her Les Miserables Broadway partner and Tony Award winner John Lloyd Young. But alas, this couple's duet didn't even last a year. Later followed a short fling with another Broadway singer, Theo Stockman, about which we again know very little. But after this relationship, Lea began a very serious and important chapter in her life called Cory Monty. Why these two talented and charismatic actors fell in love in real life needs no explaining. They already gained their fame from Glee when Lea took Cory to see Broadway for the first time and introduced him to her world of musical theater, which only strengthened their bond. Hard to imagine a more stable relationship than theirs. It felt like only death could do them part. Which is sadly exactly what happened. Cory passed away at the height of his career and his life. This came as a huge shock not only for Lea, but for the whole cast. The showrunners even dedicated an episode in memory of their beloved Glee Club member, calling it Quarterback. And it was heartbreaking for us all. Her personal grief turned into a public torture for Lea when the public and media started commenting on every word and move Lea made after Monteith's death. The actress disclosed that she couldn't be left in peace even when she visited Cory's grave, since the paparazzi got to her even there. If you smile, it's like she's so happy, and if you look sad, they're like, she's terrible. It's just really hard. For a long while, she felt depressed and isolated herself from others, but she said that acting in Glee helped her return her inner peace. "They're my family," told Lea. Coming back to normal, the actress began trying to get her life back together. This led her into a relationship with the dating coach and model Matthew Peets, and then her Dimension 404 co-star Robert Buckley. In July 2017, Lea started dating her longtime friend Zandy Reich, the president of All Year Round Clothing Company. A year later, Zandy proposed. "I kept saying, stop joking around," said Lea, remembering the moment of proposal, but it was so great. Lea recalled that the wedding flew by in a blink of an eye for both of them. Among her guests were Lea's Glee pals Darren Criss, Becca Tobin, and Scream Queens co-star actress Emma Roberts. Seems like Lea finally found real happiness. We hope that this fairy tale love will inspire Lea to reach higher and star in more movies and musicals, which she does so well. Dianna Agron. The authors of the show invented the character of Quinn Fabray, inspired by Regina George from Mean Girls, the night before filming began. Watch our video about other fun Glee facts that you didn't know. It's hard to imagine this character not giving others a hard time. However, at the end of the show, Quinn had a change of heart and bonded with her sworn enemy Rachel Berry. In real life though, Dianna is one of the kindest stars in Hollywood. Of course, a beauty like her always had the most handsome boyfriends. Her list includes Sebastian Stan, Alex Pettyfer, and even Dave Franco. In 2015, Dianna started dating a guitarist from Mumford & Sons, Winston Marshall, and a year later they celebrated a small, humble wedding in Morocco. We got into more details about it in our last Glee Cast Real Life Partners video. I've got to say, however, that recently I came across some worrying news that Dianna is single again. Whole of Twitter turned into a hunting ground for the star's phone number. We got a feeling that there was been a rift in Winston and Dianna's marriage back in February when a picture appeared on her Instagram where another man was holding her hand and it didn't look platonic. So it seems that the actress's heart is free again. What will happen to her love life? We will keep you up to date, so don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Criss Colfer. You must know that Kurt Hummel's part did not appear in the original script until the producers saw Criss and wrote in a character specifically for him. Criss is definitely worth it. He is an openly gay man and he inspires other queer guys to be proud of who they are. How many times did fans pray that Criss Colfer and Darren Criss were a couple in real life? But their prayers weren't heard because just like on screen, Criss is interested in long-term relationships. From 2013, Will Sherritt has been his one and only love interest. For a long while, there were only rumors about them being together as they kept being spotted here and there. But today, they openly share their love. They attend parties together and promote Colfer's movies and books that he releases one after the other. We wish Criss inspiration while we continue to follow how their relationship develops. Jane Lynch. Let's take a break from Glee Club members and talk about teachers, which make the show even better. We absolutely love Sue Sylvester. She even managed to marry herself, remember? What can I say? That's how Sue sees it. Okay, Jane Lynch, how cool are you? She is an incredible singer. Do you remember her Vogue cover? And can you imagine that she's deaf in one ear? Lynch is an open lesbian and in 2005, she was named one of Power Up's 10 Amazing Lesbian Women in Showbiz. In 2010, Lynch married a psychologist, Lara Embry, but after 3 years of marriage, the couple broke up. Lara and I have decided to end our marriage. This has been a difficult decision for us, as we care very deeply about one another. We ask for privacy as we deal with this family matter, wrote Lynch. Soon after that, there were rumors of Jane's new affair with the actress Jennifer Shane. Jane admitted that the rumors are true, but told everyone that she's not planning on getting married. No, we're very happy the way we are. I was married for a little while and it just wasn't for me. I got gay divorced. So there. Jane and Jennifer have 3 dogs which like to sleep in bed with their owners, and if this is not a happy family, I don't know what is. Darren Criss. Even though Criss claims that he was inadvertently raised by the gay community as he grew up in his parents' creative environment, he did not turn out gay as his fans expected. More so, he is devoted to his girlfriend of 8 years who last January became his fiance. On his Instagram, Darren wrote, "Mia and I have had 7.5 years of fun, wacky, wonderful, crazy adventures together, and I'm happy to announce that we're kicking those adventures up a notch. We're going for it, to boldly go where neither of us have gone before, engage." Only a month after this announcement, the couple got married. The lucky lady is Mia Swire, a TV producer and director who worked on projects like Glee, Scream Queens, The Mindy Project, New Girl, Raising Hope, and others. It looks like this is the true love we all wish to have. He even mentioned her in his Emmy-winning speech. "Oh my God, you guys are witnessing the most extraordinary moment of my life thus far. My darling Mia, you roll the windows down and pump the music up in my life." Cord Overstreet. Since we touched on the topic of Glee Club's most eligible bachelors, it only makes sense we mention this handsome guy. It will come as no surprise, of course, that he has a long list of exes, which include Brooke Butler, Halston Sage, Ashley Benson, Emma Roberts, Josie Loren, and Dallas Lovato. Cord dated Emma Roberts at the peak of his Glee career. The two were on and off for a while, saying that they are too different. At the end of their second attempt, things took a very bad turn. Witnesses said that they posed for pictures. After that, the two were on opposite sides of the VIP section. It's a really immature relationship. All they did was fight. Last year, Cord had an affair with one of the most popular British actresses, Emma Watson. Emma swore that she would never date a celebrity in her life, but the couple kept being caught canoodling here and there. They were even spotted leaving the Oscars after party together. But soon, the couple stopped appearing together, and quoting some insiders, things just haven't worked out between them, and they are both now single. Overstreet did not stay single for too long. As soon after, he began to be seen with a model Amanda Pizzicato. pony, and from fresh photos of the two together, we think that their romance is ongoing. How long will Cord last in a relationship this time, and will he ever be able to settle? Share your opinions with us in the comments below. Kevin McHale. Many still don't know that in real life, Kevin is not handicapped and doesn't need a wheelchair to move around. Those who don't follow him on Twitter might not know that last year Kevin came out as a gay via a tweet. He's dating an actor called Austin McKenzie. They attend red carpet events where they like to fool around and have a good laugh together. Happy days for them. All the while, we are expecting to hear news about their wedding. We only managed to cover a small part of Glee cast's personal lives, but if you like this video, we'll be sure to film part 2. So give us a like, leave a comment, and if we see a strong feedback, we will make another video for you. Stay awesome, folks!